Have you ever done something that you're ashamed of or made a stupid mistake? I'm going to talk about why that happens and how to deal with it in just a minute. Hi, I'm Eric with ericdieter.com. I'm an author, a life coach, a small business owner, entrepreneur. I live my life from the inside out, and I want to help you do the same. And if you would like to live your best life ever, click the subscribe button below and the bell for notifications so you won't miss anything new. Have you ever acted in a way that seems contrary to who you are? You've done something stupid, or you've done something mean, you've done something unkind, you've gotten angry, you've lost your temper, you've done something that is out of character with who you want to be. Why do we do things that we're ashamed of, and where do those things come from? Here's the truth that most of us don't admit to ourselves. We're not all good. We're not all bad. We're a mixture. And no matter how good we think we are, there's oftentimes that we'll do things that are bad. No matter how loving and kind we say we want to be, there's going to be times when we are hurtful. There'd be times that we are mean. Those things are part of who we are just as much as the things that are good. And no matter how hard we try, those things that we don't like about ourselves, those parts that we would say are ugly about ourselves, are there below the surface. And given the right circumstances, given the right triggers, they come out without us even being aware that we're doing them. So when you get tired, when you're hungry, when you're stressed, when you're distracted, when you feel pressure, when you get angry, those things that we don't like about ourselves, those things that we say are ugly, sometimes we'll come out and we look at what we did or what we said and we say to ourselves, that's not who I am. But in our minds, there's a disconnect because we are saying, that's not who I am. But on the other hand, we see this thing that we've done that was stupid or mean or ugly and realize that, yes, we did that thing. But then we're saying, that's not who I am. There's a disconnect in our minds between who we say we are and our behavior, and it causes distress. So what do you do about it? Are you lying to yourself when you say, that's not who I am? Let me give a little bit of a different perspective. There are three elements to what I talk about here on this channel and in my coaching practice. One is living from your identity, living from the inside out. The second is forgiveness, and the third is love and gratitude. These three all work together. Your identity is who you say you are. Your identity is made up of the stories that you tell yourself about who you are. When you say, that's not who I am, but your actions are different, remember, you're not all good. You're not all evil. You're a mixture. So when bad things come up, when ugly things come up, and you do things that you say are out of character with your identity, with who you want to be, or who you say you are, you're perfectly right to say, that's not who I am. But the disconnect between your actions and who you say you are, you have to deal with that psychological tension, because if you continue doing things that you say that you don't want to, it causes distress and anxiety and depression because you're acting in ways that deny who you say you are. This is where the second element of what I talk about comes in. Forgiveness. Forgiveness is forgiving others, but is also forgiving yourself. Realize that there are things inside of you that are ugly, that there are things inside of you that you don't want to be, and you're not going to eliminate those totally. So when those things come out, you have to choose to forgive yourself. Now, the goal for self-improvement is that you gradually begin to live and act the way that you say that you are. Now, the more that you pay attention to your thinking, the more you pay attention to the stories of who you say you are, the more you're going to live in line with those stories. Most people go through their lives without paying attention. When you're living on autopilot, it's more likely that the ugly things inside of you will come up when you get tired or distressed or you get the right trigger. Those things are going to come out. But when you're living intentionally, when you're living according to your stories of who you say you are and paying attention to what you're doing and not just living your life on autopilot, there's going to be less of a gap between the things that you do and who you say you are. That's what living from the inside out is. That's what the goal is, to live according to your identity. But when you don't, when you do things that are out of character with who you say you are, you have to forgive yourself. You have to say, that's not who I want to be. That's not who I am. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to live on purpose. I'm going to be kind. I'm going to pay attention. Wherever it is that you have fallen short, forgive yourself and remind yourself of the story of who you say you are, who you want to be. As you continue to do this, forgive yourself, let it go, and remind yourself that you're living intentionally, that you're living from the inside out. This is who I am. This is who I choose to be. This is what I choose to think. You will find your life changing. It doesn't happen overnight. That's why forgiveness and loving yourself enough to let those things go and refocus on who you want to be is so important. It is possible to live from the inside out. It is possible to live on purpose, to stop doing those things that are ugly, to stop doing those things that you say, that's not who I am. That's what I talk about here on this channel. That's what I talk about with my coaching clients, is to bridge that gap between what you do and who you say you are. Living from the inside out. If you want more information about how to live your best life ever, click subscribe and you won't miss out on anything new. I'll see you next time.